sad but true. It's about a girl that I once knew. She took my love, then ran around with every single guy in town. Whoa, 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 nah, 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 hey, hey, I'm bad, hey, hey, I'm bad, hey, hey. Oh.
Hello and welcome back to Smile Radio. We are on our own tonight, so our producer has had to be somewhere tonight, so we are on our own, so bear with us. Connor is just working out all of the things on the...
Yeah, I think I'm doing all right.
Yeah, we've done all right.
We're just going to have to rely on feedback from you guys that are watching on Facebook Live and, of course, listening.
Yeah, let us know if we're doing all right.
Yeah, not just that, just with regards to the audio levels and things like that, because we're... I'm just trying to get my head around it. So thanks to you guys that have already joined us on Facebook Live. Chelsea Dyson, Zoe Shackleton, Rachel Sharp,
right,
amongst those. So if I won't be as frequent as Rich. Richie says hi to everybody and what have you. I'm not going to be able to do that, but there you go. I'm not being ignorant. So go on, Zoe. We've not really done a real intro as such.
We've got loads to talk about. Lots going on in the world of rugby and football this week. We're going to look forward in football to the Europa League final, which is taking place next week, I believe, while we're on air. There's been news out. Obviously, you as an Arsenal fan, you can give us your opinion on it. Henrik Mkhitaryan will not be playing in the Europa League final. So we've got that to talk about. What are you smirking at, darling?
No. I'm just getting my head around all this. I think we're doing all right so far, aren't we?
We are, yeah. So we've got that to talk about. Loads of other stuff in football. So give us your thoughts. What topics you want us to discuss?
Well, I think.
And then just moving on to rugby league as well. Lots of ins and outs. Josh Jones has rejoining. Not rejoining, is going to Hull FC next year. Wakefield have got a new signing. Stefan Ratchford out for 12 plus weeks. He was injured, so that's a big blow for Warrington. We'll discuss who we think will take his place and how they go about playing with him without him in the side. And it's the Magic Weekend, obviously, this weekend in Super League at Anfield. We'll be discussing that and giving our predictions, and we'll look back at last week's games as well.
Yeah, good stuff. I think we should start with the Henrik Mkhitaryan business.
Yes, I know you're an Arsenal fan. I just need to adjust my chair because I'm a bit high up today. Yeah. Just getting me...
Right, I'm in zone now. I'm comfy. I've got my head around how this works.
It's easy enough. It will just start starting it off, won't it? So, right. Richard says you're doing a fantastic job. Thanks for standing in. We won't need you next week, Rich.
Oh, it's easy.
We'll be able to do it on his own.
Yeah, so just obviously on Mkhitaryan there.
He's not travelling with the team because of his, because he's Armenian, isn't he? And they're playing the final in
Azerbaijan.
Yeah, and there's all the politics and what have you. And he's basically fears for his safety if he would travel out there. He's missed games there before, I do believe, when they've played there before. So, as an Arsenal fan, what's your take on it, Connor?
I think it's first and foremost, you've got to take health and safety into consideration. I think that.
Yeah,
it's
unfortunate that he feels like he can't go because
the be all and end all is basically, you know, the worry about his safety, and a lot of people have said it's as bad as if he goes, he could get killed.
Yeah.
No, I'm sorry, but regardless of whether it's a European final, whatever, you can't take those risks. And you know, I think Arsenal have sort of been saying for a while, can you give us reassurances There's going to be there's going to be safe, and they're like, well, no, we can't. Though, so I think they've come.
How can they can't really give them assurances, can they?
Well, that's what I'm saying.
I would say, because I don't. If he's on the pitch, around the pitch, travel like with the team, obviously they can't give him assurances that he is going to be 100% safe.
Yeah, exactly. So it's one of them, isn't it, that they've just had to do what they've had to do, I think.
Mm-hmm. And there has been calls for him to, not for him, sorry, for the final to be moved. Because obviously he's fearing for himself. But I don't think that...
It's just too far down the line now, exactly. Isn't it? I think, you know, why wasn't this brought into
consideration
in the group? You know, because I'm not being funny, Arsenal are a favourite to be in the final at the start of the competition, so why haven't they looked down those possible routes and just said, look...
Yeah, no, exactly, but if you're honest, because the final stadium isn't that decided well before the competition even starts.
Exactly.
So, whether Arsenal are favourites or not, they can't just make that decision on whether... they get to the final or not.
No, but they've got to have some sort of
But they should have it in
place.
A neutral...
No,
in a neutral.
What I'm saying is they should have... Arsenal are going to be there or thereabouts, so they should have a plan, they should have a backup stadium ready. I'm not saying change it just in case Arsenal get there, because there's no guarantees in football, as you know, but I think they should probably just have had a backup stadium that says, right, yep, we're ready to go, should Arsenal get to the final. Because it's a player who's missing out on a European final... Or because of stupidity that's going on in the world.
Stupidity.
It's as simple as that for me.
Yeah, and it's not fair on him either. He'll be wanting more than anything to play in that final. And he can't. I don't think the calls for it to be moved will come to fruition. I think it'll be still played there. And unfortunately, he'll just be missing out.
Dave Smith, the final should not have been played there in the
exactly,
first
Dave,
instance.
Exactly, Dave. Yeah, exactly. That shouldn't have even been a consideration. I don't think, because if they know what everything that's going on in that country, surely they should play it somewhere else.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, stupidity.
But on the Europa League final, I think.
Yeah, we'll
would Mkhitaryan have played anyway? Probably not. So, perhaps
I don't think Arsenal will lose because he's not there.
Well, Mkhitaryan probably wouldn't have been in the starting team anyway.
Exactly.
You're picking a side, so you know, I don't think it's a great. They're not going to lose too much with Mkhitaryan not being there. Obviously, he's useful to bring off the bench, and he would have added something. But it's not the be all and end all, and I still. My prediction's not changed. I'm still going to go for Arsenal.
What is your prediction?
I think I went for Arsenal. I didn't give a score, did I? I think I went Arsenal to win it in 90.
They're playing out there on Wednesday.
Is it Wednesday next week?
I think so. Unless someone wants to tell me any different. Or is it... Because it's the playoff final as well, isn't it? The Championship playoff final next Wednesday. So I don't know whether they're on the same day or...
Being on the same day.
Am I getting them mixed up?
Ain't the playoff final normally on a bank holiday Monday?
Could well be.
I'm sure it's normally on the bank holiday Monday.
I thought
Monday.
It was on Wednesday when I looked. Or it might be that, and it might be... I'll have a look. Double check.
We're on for just an hour tonight, aren't we?
We are, yeah.
We're
Part
on for
well.
Just an hour.
Well, yeah, Richard's had to go to hospital. He's all right, but... he got something in his eye, didn't he, when he was decorating the other day?
Yeah, he's got he's got a lovely looking eye.
Yeah, he wasn't wearing goggles when he was chopping up wood, and he's got something in his eye, and he's got to go to hospital. So we're only on for an hour tonight. So we're a quarter of an hour short tonight, but we'll be back at normal time next week. So what are your thoughts then? Do you think, what would you say? 2-0, did you say?
Yeah, I'll go 2-0. No, 3-1. I think Chelsea have got a goal in them, Hazard potentially his last game, but I'll go 3-1.
Yes, the Europa League final's on Wednesday and the playoff final is bank holiday Monday.
Yeah, I thought it was. I don't know where we got Wednesday from.
I think I'd got them confused with
each other.
Yeah. So. Well, we can discuss that as well then.
We can.
I forgot it was on Monday.
Obviously, last week we were in absolute. We came off air before we knew the outcome of.
Oh yeah, of course we did. Yeah.
The Leeds and Derby one. So. Yeah. An absolute. You know, I thought Leeds were cruising. Obviously, they had that first leg 1-0. In the second leg, they got off to a flying start 2-0, and then I'm not quite sure what happened. From there, but obviously not good enough, and Gaetano Berardi, not for the first time in his Leeds United career, getting sent off. So that
kind of topped it off, didn't it?
Topped it off, it did, yeah.
They went 1-0 up, obviously, and I think, did we come off air just after half time? Should we play a song? Do you want to play a song and then we can figure it out afterwards?
Yes, we'll break.
So bear with us for those of you who were listening on the app. We have had some technical difficulties. Yeah, it is paused on my phone. So we'll be back after this song.
Village Grove Nursery in Wakefield has been providing the highest standard of childcare for over 22 years. Situated on East Moor Road, we are close to the M1 and M62 motorway network and also convenient for Wakefield City Centre, schools and major places of employment. For more details, check out our website at www.collegegrovenursery.co.uk or give us a call on 01924 200 120 to arrange a visit. College Grove, a special nursery which takes a hand, opens a mind and touches a heart.
Ah,
we're back.
We're back.
We had to just stop for a song because we were experiencing some technical difficulties on Facebook Live, but we're back and you can hopefully hear us all right and see our faces.
Hopefully, yeah. Let us know if you've got any problems. I hope we've not.
I think we saved that quite well, don't you?
Yeah, yeah, we've done all right there. We've done all right. You missed quite a large bit of one of my favourite songs, actually, Culture Beat, Mr. Vane. Absolute belter. Love it.
Oh, dear.
And there we are. We're back. We're back.
Right,
back
so we were discussing before we got confused as to what date the Europa League final and playoff finals were on. Playoff final is Monday and Europa League final is on Wednesday.
It's an interesting one, Matt.
We were discussing the Leeds and Derby game that we missed part of last Wednesday when we were on the show. And Leeds looked, when they went 1-0 up at home in front of that crowd, you'd think, easy. What happened? Just capitulated.
Yeah, well, they had that man sent off that didn't help. And once Derby got the tails up, Leeds were always on the back foot from there. And it sets up this playoff final quite well, obviously. Mm-hmm. Villa have been good for a while, but Derby are going to have that confidence and yeah.
Well, I think Villa have been a team that were all right at the start of the season, but then towards the end of the season, they've got some good results, got themselves into the playoffs, and it'll be a good game against Derby.
Yeah, it will be. I'm going to probably go for Derby, I think.
Yeah, right. I want Derby to win. I want Derby to go up. I'm going to go Derby to win 2-1.
Yeah, I'll go Derby to win 3-1.
3-1?
Yeah, 3-1. There we go.
We shall see. We've got all of that. And then, of course, it's the Champions League final as well coming up. But we can talk about that on next week's show.
So where are we at now? What we got now?
We can do football, we can do rugby, whatever you want, darling.
What we got on the agenda?
I just looked through Sky Sports and BBC Sport app this morning. In connection with, obviously, the Europa League final, could that be Maurizio Sarri's last game for Chelsea? I was reading an article this morning that Juventus and Roma are both interested in bringing him across there.
Yeah, I think he'll be gone at end of season. He's on borrowed time anyway.
He is, yeah. And I don't think his heart's really in it anymore. I think they've had a couple of seasons where they've been mediocre. I know they've finished quite highly this season and they've got the into the Europa League final, but I don't think they're playing the football that Chelsea know that they can play.
No, they're not. They're not very mediocre.
They're very average compared to the Chelsea side you'd see of a couple of years ago. But
and when they lose Hazard, they're going to be even worse.
Yeah, they are. But they've got decent players. They've got a decent enough team. But they need to be making some signings in the off season. Rebuild. Get rid of Sarri for me. Bring a new manager in because he's not done anything really since he's been there. I don't think. He's not convinced me.
No, he's not me either. No.
Get some fresh blood. Hazard will be gone. We all know that. They need to refresh, don't they?
Yeah, absolutely.
And then there's talk of Petr Cech as well coming back as a director. Yeah, that's
an interesting one.
Just
in the contest text of the Europa League final.
Well, he's come out and said, hasn't he, that our focus is on playing that game for Arsenal.
Yeah,
and he'll think about his future after that.
What does Unai Emery think about that? Obviously, he's gonna go to Chelsea, and be behind the scenes next season. You know, it's a funny one. It's a funny one. Petr Cech's been the keeper throughout all the Europa League games, but Bernd Leno is the keeper in the Premier League. Does he pick Leno? What would you do if one of your goalkeepers were going to the opposition after that game?
I'll pick the other keeper.
Yeah, I would in any normal situation, but I do think Petr Cech has been the ultimate pro, hasn't he?
Well, yeah. Who is the better keeper?
Well, obviously Leno is, Petr Cech's been the Europa League keeper,
yeah.
And the plan has always been for Petr Cech to play in the final.
Yeah, well, then you'd play Cech then, wouldn't you?
But what I'm saying is, he's going to Chelsea after that game. So who do you pick?
Well, it's not been confirmed yet.
He's going to Chelsea. I think Sky Sports News tweeted it the other day. Said now Petr Cech's going to.
I don't know if it's been announced properly. I think it was just, but I don't think it's been confirmed yet. But I might be wrong. We should really do our homework, shouldn't we, before we come on air? But yeah, I'm not sure in that situation. If he's played all the Europa League games.
Yeah, it's been confirmed yesterday.
If he's played all the Europa League games, then he should play in the final.
Yeah, but he's going to. It's a massive decision, I think. I think I'd probably pick the other keeper. I'd pick Leno. She's good. I think I would, and just say, look, it is what it is. It's an hard situation to be put in. But you're going to this club at the end of this game. There's a lot of emotion in it for you, a lot of things that's going to be going through your head. It's going to be the talking point ahead of the game. Leno plays. It's not, you know, Leno's sole focus. I'm not saying Cech's sole focus isn't on Arsenal, which it probably 100% will be. But Leno's not got anything in his mind. Chelsea's just another game for him.
Yeah.
But Cech, it's not. So that's just my opinion on that one. I'd go with Leno, I think.
Yeah, I mean, you're probably right. I'm not really fussed either way. Both equally good keepers.
Well, Cech's past it now, isn't he? I think he's just one of them, isn't it, that is just the cup keeper, so he's sticking with him and wants to bow out in a good way. But we'll see. It wouldn't surprise me if Cech did play. It's just that's probably the stance I'd take to pick Leno. Definitely.
Well, we shall see.
We shall.
But yeah, that was all the sort of footballing stuff that I'd written down. If there's anything that anybody else wants to discuss with us, get involved on the comments on Facebook Live, because we are back on now.
No Ben Gummersall tonight, have we?
He did message me on Facebook, actually.
Did he?
Saying, I'll just double check.
We'll have to get him on.
He says, will Hazard stay or go? If Sarri goes, bring back Lampard.
Yeah, Ben, I think he'll go, regardless of Sarri. I think Hazard will go. Sarri, yeah, I think he'll go. I think bring Lampard back. It wouldn't surprise me, to be honest, that one.
What, as manager?
It wouldn't surprise me,
but I think he's all right at Derby. I don't think he's got enough experience as a manager yet to take on a job like Chelsea. I've said it before. I think we've discussed it before on the show. I wouldn't give him that job.
Yeah, I don't think I would. But he's a Chelsea. He knows Chelsea inside out. He knows what it means to play for the badge, for the club. It wouldn't be the worst appointment in the world.
No, it wouldn't. I'm not saying that, but I don't available? Think. I don't know, to be honest. If he does leave, I don't know who the candidates would be to replace him.
No, exactly. So Frank Lampard's top at least for me.
But then again, I've not really done my research, so I don't know what managers are available or what. So, But we shall see. We'll get the Europa League final out of the way first. But I definitely don't think he'll be here another season.
No, you're probably right. Probably right. Well, I think we're coming towards the half-hour point now. So we'll break for a song, and then we'll go straight into rugby league, I think.
Yeah, that's fine. First half, I think we've been a bit all over the place trying to get us bearings and everything. So hopefully the second half of the show will be a bit better.
Bit of Ricky Martin here for
this
you.
This is a good shout. This is a good shout.
Enjoy.
In a funky cheap hotel, she took my heart and she took my money. She must have slipped me a sleeping pill. She never drinks the water, makes you order French champagne.
Looking for custom-made curtains and blinds? Get yourself down to the Curtain Shop. Visit our showrooms at Kingsway Ossett or High Street Normington. For all your curtains, blinds and upholstery needs, go to the Curtain Shop. And if you mention Smile Radio, you'll qualify for free lining for all custom-made curtains. The Curtain Shop, Kingsway Ossett and High Street Normington. The Curtain Shop.
The Curtain Shop.
We're back.
We're back. Straight on to rugby league.
Yeah, so
we've only got half an hour left.
I'm glad I've been a bit stressed this show.
Why? What do you mean you've been stressed?
With all the technical issues. Stressing me out. I want Richard to come and do it next week.
Oh, thanks. Oh, great. Well, yeah.
No, you're doing a really good job. I'm very proud of you.
Right. Okay. So.
So there's been quite a bit of news, ins and outs of different clubs and what have you. But should we start with last week's games and our predictions? Have you got them written down on your phone?
Did I write them down on
my
phone?
No, I think I wrote them down.
Yeah, you did.
All right, just talk for a bit, darling. I'll try and find them.
They'll be over there somewhere. We did them somewhere. I'm sure we did. Have you got them?
No, that's old.
Oh, never mind. We don't need to do them, do we?
Yeah, no.
Yeah, never mind.
We'll sort that out next week.
On the recruitment across Super League, Josh Jones has been announced as a Hull FC player.
Yeah, but that's for next year, isn't it? That's their first signing of 2020. Good signing for them. I think he was wanted by a lot of clubs.
Until they realised how much money he went on.
Yeah, and then Hull. Unbelievable. What do you think he's worth that?
I think the money is going to be on. Proposed.
Reportedly, yeah. He's ridiculous.
I won't give him half of it. I won't give him half of it.
No, I think it's if correctly what I've seen.
120,000.
Yeah, if I've seen that correctly, that is ridiculous.
He's the most average player in Super League. He has been since he came through at Saints. Is somebody you won't mind having in your side, but for 120k.
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't have him in the side for
120k.
I wouldn't have him. I wouldn't have him in the side for that.
He wouldn't get near my side, I'm afraid. But there you go. Another new player in Super League joined immediate effect to the mighty Wakefield, Kelepi Tanginoa. Kelepi Tanginoa. Yeah. He's going to play on Saturday.
Straight into training, wasn't he,
straight
this week?
Straight in, yeah. Got off the plane Monday afternoon. I was in training yesterday, trained today. He's all ready to go. Looks in good shape. Strange to see a forward, an overseas forward, come from Australia to Wakefield and look in shape. but there we go. He looks
kind
in shape.
It's quite suddenly, hasn't it?
Yeah, I think
he's been in the plan, yeah.
It's not really happened suddenly. I think it's been in the pipeline for a long time. Obviously, just become common knowledge this last week or so. But Chris Chester says it's a player he's been looking at
and
wanting to sign for 2 years.
Yeah.
Failed on 2 attempts. So to go back a third time, it must show that he can add a lot to this Wakefield side. And I'm sure he will. It's no secret we need a few extra bodies, especially at the minute. A big sign at this stage gives them a boost, and is a lot of Manly fans and people from near NRL are sad to see him go, which probably speaks volumes. Still young, only 25-year-old, and he's in good shape. He's a big human.
2 years,
isn't it? He signed for two and a half. He's signed for the remainder of this, and then
another 2 years
20 and 21
that.
As well. So they're obviously seeing a lot in him to tie him down long term. And a big signing. Justin Horrow he's retired. Has Justin not been announced yet, but he was retiring at the end of the season. So, he's just been released by mutual consent to allow Kelepi to come in.
Freeing up that space. On the subject of Horrow, I think he's been good, solid, but he's... he's not really a game changer for me.
He's just average. Yeah. He'll play any position you tell him to. And well, that would have been harsh of me actually saying he's just average. He does a job without winning.
Yeah, without winning the games.
And he was good at Catalan and then came to Wakefield and he's done.
He's done all right, exactly.
But yeah, for Horro, for his age and probably the wage he was on and the overseas quota spot in the back of your mind as well, I think.
It's a good swap for me.
So interesting, and I'd be interested to see how it goes on Saturdays. He's obviously only played 4 times, I think, for Manly this year. He's played 4 in 9, something like that.
Yeah, so he's not really.
But he's featured in the squad, so he's been, he's on the fringes. So four out of nine, it's almost half the games.
Yeah.
So he's not. You wouldn't say he's lacking too much fitness, or he might not be as sharp as some of the guys out there. It's fit enough to play and he's thrown straight in. I asked Chezzy today. I says, "Will he play?" I mean, I knew he would did just for an interview, and he went, "Well, yeah, he's not here for a holiday." I said to him last week that he's going to be straight in. So straight in and a big game, Magic Weekend. I was at Anfield for the launch on Monday with Kyle Wood, and the stadium's great.
I'm quite jealous that he went because I love Liverpool. I love Anfield.
Well, I don't know what you love about Liverpool.
not the city, but the club.
Yeah, the stadium's great, and behind the scenes, the changing rooms, the tunnel area, everything's great. But it's just for a Magic Weekend, it's just completely the wrong location for me.
Yeah, it's in the middle of nowhere. I don't know why they decided to move it from Newcastle, to be honest. Newcastle's a perfect place. It's in the near enough bang in the city centre. You've got places around it. And not only that, but Liverpool's got other stuff going on this weekend. I just think it's wrong timing and the wrong stadium. And obviously they've shown that by not selling enough tickets. So we'll see what it's like and what it looks like on telly, because obviously all the games have been shown on Sky. But for me, it was the wrong decision to move it there.
Should have stayed at Newcastle, Dave Smith. I completely agree, 100%.
Yeah, I agree.
Why try and fix something that's not broken?
Yeah, fans loved it.
With a bit more smarter marketing from the body, from Super League, from the NFL, I think that it could have grown even further. Everybody, all the fans that go are going to go again because they've enjoyed it. It's just about attracting more. And I think you've moved it to Anfield, you're missing a lot of fans that have enjoyed it at Newcastle. And the thing is, I was having this conversation earlier.
They're not marketing it to anybody else other than rugby league fans.
They should be marketing it to
everybody. And they've already got that strong base in Newcastle where your rugby league fans will go. Other people will be interested in it, and then you can build on that. But moving it to Anfield, where it's in the middle of nowhere, where nobody's really, not even rugby league fans are interested in going, I think it's just a bad move all round.
I had this conversation earlier. We're a northern sport, and we're just completely, for me, well, I say we're a northern sport, we're just very negative. Everything's so negative. So you're going to get people that, they enjoyed it at Newcastle. Oh, it's changed. I'm not going. And that's just the mentality a lot of people have. And I think it's just a stupid decision to move it from Newcastle. It was successful. Yes, they're saying, oh, we need some fresh blood and we need to make it more successful. But it's great, you know, that you're never gonna fail. I'll tell you now. You are never, ever, ever going to fill a stadium of the ilk of Newcastle, of Liverpool, a football stadium. You're not going to do it unless you go to one that's all 50,000, 25. It's never going to be full for the full weekend at all. Just leave it how it is, you know, and just try and improve what you've got. And that was a good thing at Newcastle. I've not had any negative press about it at all. I'm hearing a lot about Liverpool already, and we've not even experienced it. I just really worry come 2:15 on Saturday when I'm sat there waiting for our lads to kick off. I'm worried about what.
There'll be no one in the stadium.
There's going to be absolutely nobody
because
in the stadium.
I'm not being funny,
Wakefield's
against Catalans. I mean, Catalans aren't going to bring any. there'll be a couple of thousand Wakefield fans, maybe not even that, I don't know what the ticket sales are like, and you're not really going to get other fans like your fans of Hull and Saints and all the other teams are probably not going to come in early to watch that game.
They're not, and I wouldn't want to. And
also another thing for me as well is, why have they got rid of the derby games?
Well, that's what I was just going to come on to.
Because it's absolutely, you've got Wakefield Catalans, you've got London Leeds, which actually is arguably quite exciting given the status of both sides.
Yeah, it is now
sides.
In the predicament
exactly,
they're in. But
yeah.
When you want to sell tickets prior to the event at the start of the season, when the
why are Hull FC playing? I can't remember what the thing. Yeah, and then Salford are playing Hull Kia. Why aren't Hull FC? Why aren't Hull FC playing Hull Kia? And why aren't Wakefield playing Cass?
Yeah, why? I get it.
Ridiculous.
I get it.
That's what the Magic Weekend's all about. You have your derby games. It's just ridiculous.
But to Wakefield are playing Catalan, so the least supporters in the whole weekend, they're not going to have many.
Yeah.
Wakefield themselves haven't sold a great amount of tickets. I think at the minute they're eighth out of all the Super League clubs. So there's only four teams below them that have sold less tickets than Wakefield, which, considering the success Wakefield, I say success, but they've been at the top end of the table for the past 3 years, that's not good. That's not great. But having said that, you've got to look at everything that they've done. They've changed it to Liverpool. The fixtures are rubbish. Wakefield, Catalans, it doesn't draw any great attention. And the fact that it's expensive. You know, it's expensive to go for a weekend, and you've got to look at it like this. Last weekend, Wakefield were away at London. That's an expensive weekend. They've got Catalans in a couple of weeks coming up. They've got the Cup quarter-final next week. You're a Wakefield fan. 90% of Wakefield fans are not going to be able to afford to go to London, followed by Magic Weekend, followed by the Cup quarter-final, followed by Catalans away.
No, exactly.
Not going to be able to do it. You're picking and choosing your fixtures. Mm-hmm. And if I'm picking and choosing my fixtures, I would have picked straight up, Cup quarter-final away at Saints.
Yeah, and Catalans.
And then it's, you know, some will pick Catalans or whatever, but you lose out on a lot of fans just because it's expensive to go to the Magic Weekend and watch your team when you've got those fixtures in the space of a month within each other. So that is a big...
I mean, we've obviously Wakefield play Catalans in a couple of weeks in Catalans. I'd much rather go there if I could afford it than go to Magic Weekend somewhere that I'm not really bothered about going.
Well, and I think I wish I had the choice if I could go to Catalan, but there we go.
And I think that'll reflect on what's the word I'm looking for? On the attendance as well. It is an expensive weekend, and with fixtures that I'm not overly enamoured by, you're not gonna go, are you?
No, not at all.
But we'll see. I mean, we can do our predictions before we finish, can't we?
Yeah, we can. I'm just thinking of the other thing. I'm just thinking in the back of my mind which fixture I'm excited for the most. Warrington Wigan for me. And even then, I'm thinking Warrington's still going to win that game.
Well, we said that, but we thought they'd beat Hull
last week,
didn't we?
As daft as it sounds,
I'm most
Leeds in London.
I was just about to say that. I'm most looking forward to now, given the status, given the sort of league table, obviously, there's Hull KR, Leeds and London all on 8 points at the bottom. The 4 points are 4 points below the rest of the Super League. And that's going to be a really interesting game for me. Leeds just look bereft of any imagination, any leadership, any quality on the field. I went to do the Leeds Cass game on Thursday, and they were just Cass really had to get out of second gear on Thursday.
I thought both sides were poor.
Yeah, and Cass just about edged it, but Leeds were just there was just no imagination. They couldn't. Their discipline was awful. The only bright spot was the Matt Parcell try, and that was it, and they only scored one try. And London, I mean, I wasn't there, but I was listening to the commentary on Radio Leeds. And it just, they just sounded awful. I mean, Wakefield sounded awful, but London just looked like they'd got more enthusiasm. They were up for it more, and I think London will do one on Leeds on Saturday.
Yeah, I thought London...
Sunday, sorry.
I thought London, right, and I thought for a large part of the season that London would win games just on effort and enthusiasm, on guts. London, some of the shape they threw at Wakefield last week was... It was great, and I'm pleased for Morgan who was getting a run in the halves, and I think he's really coming into his own on that right edge there. He's got a lovely combination with Alex Walker from fullback.
Mm.
But Jordan Abdul as well, with Morgan Smith coming into the halves and just not doing a great... probably sounds wrong when I say not doing a great deal.
Yeah, well, he still managed to score four tries, didn't he?
I'm on about Morgan Smith coming into sides and saying he's not doing a great deal, but he's doing those little things that allows Abdul to run. You know, and Danny Ward said that he's challenged Jordan Abdul to run with the ball more. He might not be the quickest, but he's deceptive when he runs, and he's got that knack. And he even had it at Hull, that knack of just scoring tries and just being in the right place and being dangerous. And I think he stopped trying to guide a team around the park as much and try and just do everything. They're sharing the workload nicely now. And one of the tries that Abdul scored were from Morgan Smith, his halfback partner, putting a nice little kick in.
They're forming
so
a nice
got that balance. And Alex Walker is as good as anybody at fullback. As good as anybody in the competition at fullback. He's only a young lad. And he links in and chimes in really well. And they're not blessed with some great outside backs and some great forwards. But what they will do is Rhys Williams will start your sets off coming out of yardage as good as most players because he's a big lump.
Yeah.
And he takes some putting down. Your forwards, while they're not necessarily ones that can play big minutes, Eddie Batty will keep going and keep going and keep going whilst he's on the field. I was really impressed with Rob Butler as well, the prop forward, who I've not seen a great deal of, but he just kept coming and kept coming. Sadiq Adebayo didn't get much minutes off the bench, but when he did come on, he was good. I thought Jay Pitts, for the second time against Wakefield this season, were real good on that left edge. Mm. They've got a lot of good players of London that probably don't get the credit they deserve. And the key thing as well, their spine now, they know what it is. Alex Walker at fullback, Morgan Smith, Jordan Abdul, James Cunningham at hooker, interchanging with Pelissier.
Mm.
That
it's working.
Is a spine now that they know, they've become accustomed to. I know at the start of the season, I forgot the hooker who started round one. I forgot who it is. Is it Fozzard? He was the hooker. And there was Cunningham and Abdul in the halves. And they just... whilst they were good, that just probably lacked that little bit of guile, that little bit of shape. They found the right combination now. James Cunningham is a better hooker than he is halfback.
And
the spine is doing the business at the minute for them.
Yeah, and obviously it was a good result for them at the weekend against Wakefield. I think they've had some. They've obviously been on the wrong end of a lot of results and run of losses, but they've been there or thereabouts in all of the games, so they're not. They're not far off, and I think that win against Wakefield will give them a boost. I think they'll go on and beat Leeds on Sunday because I think they've got much more structure. They've got they're more imaginative, and I think Leeds will really struggle against them because I think Leeds are really struggling at the minute, and I don't see where their next win's going to come from.
No, neither do I. I'm struggling to see where a Leeds win's coming from.
Their win, if it's going to come anywhere, will come on Sunday against London, you would think. But the way they're at now and after the way they played on Thursday and they have been doing the past couple of weeks, I'm going to favour London for Sunday's game.
course, London have already beaten them once this season.
Yeah.
Like they have done with Wakefield, so they'll be looking for a second double
mm.
this season. Will the London Broncos? We've got about 8 minutes left. I think it's probably time to do as predictions for this weekend. Just before we do those, Ben Gummersall, thanks for joining in, mate. I can't see your comments great tonight because I'm having to turn and look back at this screen. But yeah.
Abdul is class at the level of level London are at.
Yep, I agree. Is the exact player that London need. Was a summer bash a success? I think, Ben...
If you're going off attendance, then yeah, because it were up a couple of thousand from last year. Quality was all right.
I like the fact that they've had summer bash for a while. They're not trying to overcomplicate things and move it for the sake of moving it.
It works in Blackpool. Keep it there.
The fans who go absolutely love it.
Yeah, exactly.
We can always, and we can say this till the cows come home, we could do with more fans. We need to advertise. We need to get it to more fans. We need to do that.
Do that
but
for
we can always do that, regardless of how many people are coming in anyway. I just think, look, it's great. It's great for the championship clubs. It's a perfect weekend in May. It's good for Sky and rugby league fans in general.
Yeah, it gives championship that exposure as well on Sky. Obviously, all the games were shown on Sky over the weekend. And it's a good competition as the championship. I like watching it. And they've not, like you said, they've not tried to change it. They've not tried to mess about with it. Fans love it in Blackpool. It's a good venue. If you want to get more fans like they have done this year, they've got a couple of thousand more than they did last year. Just market it. And just sort of give it a massive build up before the weekend. But I think it works. Works just fine in Blackpool.
Yeah, I think market. I just think that until they get regular games on your BBC,
on
your Sky, you're not going to get that. Look, I'm telling you now, if Championship Rugby would have had one game streamed every fortnight.
Well, they've kind of got that now, haven't they, with Toronto, but it's the same team every week.
Let's say, go to watch a Fev versus York, or a Rochdale and Swinton, or whatever. Do those games and bring it back. I don't know. Thursday nights were great for Championship, I thought, when you're talking, what now, 7-8 years ago, when they were on Thursday nights, and your Super League or Friday, Saturdays, or whenever. Or even Sunday tea time. Put a game on. If they'd have put a game on a weekly basis in the Championship, there'll have been more people at the Summer Bash. And that's a fact. Absolute fact. There'd have been more. Because you get Championship...
Yeah, it's just getting...
You get Super League fans watch and think, oh, he's a great player, him. Or, oh, we watched Rochdale and Swinton a few weeks back. They're playing it. It was a great game. They're playing again. Oh, should we go down and watch them all? And you'll get a few that tag on and do sort of that. So the comments are coming in. Dave, the quality of rugby this year at the Bash was up on previous years. Yeah, I think Championship in general, the quality's up on previous years as well. Ben, Facts beat Bulls in Challenge Cup warm-up in Blackpool. Yep, I predicted that one. But I do still think the Bulls will beat Halifax in the Cup quarter-final. Summer Bash, keep it at Blackpool. I think it's great. It's an absolute great.
Yeah, and Championship Rugby, like Dave just said, the quality is getting better and better each year, and I think it was really good to watch some of the games. I didn't watch all of them, but...
Yeah, I watched a couple on Sunday. I think it's great. I went a couple of years back to the Summer Bash. Well, no, actually, I'm lying. We planned to go to the Summer Bash. Summer Bash. We'll get us tickets on day. Turned up Saturday afternoon. Enjoyed the beers in the sun too much. Can we be bothered going to the stadium to get tickets? No. Let's watch a few on and off in the pub whilst we're out. And then watch Arsenal in the FA Cup final against Chelsea, which they won. And it was great. And then on the Sunday, we just did the same. So we didn't end up... All in all, we was in the stadium, which we planned to be at all weekend. We're in the stadium for a total of 0 minutes, 0 seconds. Well, there we go. But what I'm saying is... We didn't go to the actual stadium and watch any of the games, but the weekend itself was great. Yeah. And it probably would have been better if we'd have gone in the stadium and not necessarily, get us tickets, but only watch maybe one game on the first day or two on the second. Mm. But you can afford to do that and go in and out as you want, which is great.
Exactly.
But Blackpool, in general, for me, and the atmosphere, and it's great. And I think, yes, Ben, to answer your question, in short, was Summer Bash a success? Yes. Right, we've got just short of 3 minutes now to do those predictions. We'll have to whiz through them.
And we're not playing a song then at the end.
We're just going to cut off. We'll cut off with us. Great, run around Sue, of course. But yeah, a couple of minutes to those predictions. So Wakefield, we'll start Catalans. With the first game. Have you got the fixtures up?
Wakefield, yeah, I've got them up.
Lovely,
here.
Lovely. I just can't go against Wakefield. And the more I thought about it, when often the Wakefield perform badly twice on the spin, very, very rare. They always seem to bounce back from any hurdle they come across. I'm going to go Wakefield to win a tight game, similar to the tight game which they edged out 2016 Magic Weekend with that Jacob Miller drop goal. I don't think it'll be that tight, but my prediction is 28-24 to Wakefield.
I was going to say Catalans, but Catalans obviously...
They're missing some players as well.
Yeah, they had a fantastic win against Wigan, but Atmosphere Stadium, it was... Yeah, I'm going to go Wakefield to win. 32-24.
Right. Second
game.
We're
going to have to whiz through them even longer.
Yeah, let's go.
Hull-Huddersfield. Hull to win that one easily
Hull,
for me.
Hull 30-16.
I'm going to go 32-12 to Hull. Wigan-Warrington.
Ooh. Warrington 28, Wigan 12.
I'm going to go Warrington 24, Wigan 16. And we're not writing these down, so we'll have to go through them next week.
Yeah, we can.
Salford Hull KR, I'm going to go for a Salford win. I watched the Giants Hull KR game last week, and Hull KR just capitulated in the second half. They were poor.
Yeah, Salford for me as
Salford
well.
Salford played well, so I'm going to go Salford 30. Hull KR 18.
Is that it?
You what?
Is that it?
Leeds, London.
I'm going to go London 36, 32.
Yeah, I'm going to go London to win 2. And Saints, Castford, I'm going to go Saints to win.
Cass to win for me.
Cass to beat Saints.
Cass to beat Saints 26, 24.
Interesting.
That's going to be the shock of the weekend. Well, as time's up, we're into the last 30 seconds. Thanks to those that have tuned in. Listen, Ben Gummersall, thanks again, mate. We love all your input. Sorry it's been not as good as usual. A little bit of panic stations in the couple of minutes before the show and just getting used to it. But we'll be back in good form.
Yeah, thank you
next
all.
Next week. And if you have missed the show,
Dave, Jill, Rachel,
or you
everyone.
Want to listen back, you can listen on Podbean, Spotify, whatever, all that malarkey.
What Richard's got down to a T.
So, yeah, thank you very much, and we shall see you...
Next week.
Au revoir.